to need your math mat, your purple bingo card, and number cards that have 11 through 30 on it. So we're going to count from 1 to 30 by ones, and then we'll count by tens, and then we'll count by fives. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Good job. We went from 1 all the way to 30. Now, let's do counting by tens. Get your hands ready. Let's clap it out. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Let's do it one more time. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. Good job. Each row on our chart has 10. So we have 10 rows of 10. What you can do is show your mom and dad the trick we made where we write our numbers 1 to 10 and then put something on the end to make it 10 to 100. Now, in class we've played bingo a few times, so Miss Miranda can't play bingo with you because I can't see you right now, but you have your bingo card in front of you and you also have your number cards with that are labeled number 11 all the way to 30. So what you and a partner are going to do is you're going to mix up the cards and then one person will call it and they'll try and find it on their mat. When you use your math mat, you can use your mini erasers that are in your bag to use as tokens on your bingo card, and you can take turns. You could be the caller of the number, or you could be the one finding the number on your math mat. Make sure that you're working every day, counting by ones, counting by tens, counting by fives, and counting by twos. It's very important that you do that. So, after you practice and you've played this game, you're going to get your independent learning page out, and it's lesson 111, 111, and you're going to look on it. It's going to tell you a number word and a color word to color that number, so you have to really make sure you're paying attention, you have your crayons ready, and you get it done. I'm proud of you. Keep up the good work. I'll see you next time.